Hello, welcome to my stream. This is the first time that I'm streaming. I hope it all goes well without many technical difficulties. Please bear with me. I'm new to this streaming thing. This is the first stream where we're gonna start building the Santissima Trinidad cross section. There's the box. And let's have a look at what's inside. This is just a catalog for the Ocre products. Nothing different from the other kits that I've purchased in the past. This is the instruction manual with the pictures. And this is more open information. This is the rigging plans. The sizes and the list of pieces. Plans. Of the mast, since the cross section catches the main mast of the ship. Some more digging plans. Put it to the side. It's still gonna take a while until we need that. Box with several pieces. Change the camera to have a better look at it. Stairs, some big barrels, some brass rods, brass wire, the belay pins, more barrels, the frames and doors for the gun ports, which we are not really going to use. Same as the Santissima Trinidad. We're going to change a few things. Some blocks, dead eyes, columns. The usual. The cannons. The cannons are not the same as the cannons that came on the Santissima Trinidad. They are different. Some chain, the crow's nest. planks of the ribs of wood necessary to make this, dowels, different sizes. Hello, Marco. And hello, Nikita. Thank you for watching. We have the sails. They seem to be the same as the ones on the ship. Wooden carriages for the cannons. This is a nice improvement comparing with the ship that had metal ones. This is probably the base that helps assembling, and the remaining pieces and the structure. Last thing from the pack, some extra fabric, not sure why, but we will see as we assemble. 080, 015. 015, 015, 05, 015, 05, and this is 1.2. Most likely I'm not going to use any of these. I prefer the ones that I buy aftermarket. And the Spanish flag on the top of the mainmast. So, we already know what's inside the kit. I guess we can start the assembly. Let me just move stuff out of the way. As expected, this was the base to help the assembly. And let's start looking for this is the keel. I'll start some music during the stream. I hope it doesn't affect too much when I talk. Let me know if the volume of everything is good. I think I need a new blade. I guess I should have prepared it before. Hola, for the Spanish friend. Hello, Hugo. Just clean the tabs. Let's just have a look, see how everything fits. The jig. Seems good. Let's get the remaining ones. Scale is 190, it's the same as the ship, but it's only the cross section. It's a little slice of the ship that catches the main mast, but it's exactly the same scale as the Okri kit, 190. Same style that I did the ship. It's gonna be very weathered, very aged, paint chipping effects, patina on the copper tiles, and many other changes. A bit inspired on a cross-section build from someone called MD 1400 CS. I enjoy all his builds. He has done one cross section that he added quite a few details that are interesting, and I'm gonna do the same. Not exactly the same, but many of the details that he added I will also add. The first one is actually gonna be right now on these pieces. The grain of this wood is going horizontal and it doesn't make that much sense. The idea here, in fact, I printed this before the stream. See these pieces. Best to have died. Yeah. I'm gonna use wood veneer in. I'm gonna make these pieces. That will look it, and it will look more like this. So the three nails, then the grain will follow curvature. Careful, with the picker. And that's the idea. Right now I'm just preparing these, but that's the first thing that I'm gonna start, is exactly that. Trying to prepare the veneer to simulate those pieces that I've shown. I'm checking and the jig doesn't seem to allow. They don't touch. The jig doesn't allow them. Take a tiny bit out of here. Another from here. Thank you. Let's see now. Normally this would be glued to the keel, wouldn't be that important to have these two pieces together, because glued to the keel there wouldn't be any issue, because I need to work on this piece, make the veneers that I talked about. I need this piece to be solid, and I need to be able to work it outside of the assembly and outside of the keel. Even on the keel, I'm probably gonna make changes and do a rabbet line for the planks of the hull to tuck into, so I can do things exactly as they are intended. So sometimes we need to this is not solid enough. I'm gonna piece of wood we have left over from other stuff. These are just so that everything stays flat, except on the other side. Not much glue. This will all be to remove later. And now it better. This picture is sized. But clearly not resized enough. the computer, and I'm gonna try doing something else. Be right back. Okay, 80% of what we had before, and I think we have a good match. This is a picture from an Artemis. Anatomy of a Nelson ship. Hola Ricardo, welcome to the stream. I believe we are all aficionados. So this would be approximate template for the first piece. Oh, here are the veneers I was talking about. These are new, I never used them. I hope they are. This is one, three, two, and though it was purchased as one, 1.1, it's thin enough. Now I am simply placing shape. The vertical dimension, you can make it longer, adjust it in place after it's glued. Now, let's find the best way to cut this. Thank you, Juan. And this is the idea. You got to let it go. 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 I need to mark the center of it. And that's the idea. Now if you go from this piece, this with grain and different shade. replace this shape. So let's have a look. This is the idea. Treatment needs to improve a bit. But you get the idea. Then we'll have to do better treatment. Next piece, the grain. There you go. Like that, so that the grain follows. Of having horizontal grain. We'll have to do coating. We'll have to do auto fork. This is just starting. I think I'll end the stream here today. I